This is a patient that presented in 2015 after a motor vehicle accident with almost acute proptosis. And usually for pulsatile proptosis with injury, most of the times you'll find communication between the carotid and the cavernous sinus, what we call the carotid cavernous fistula, which causes increase in the flow and then dilatation of the superior thalamic vein, as you can see over here. These are the fracture sites of the orbital wall, and all these are the communications that you see between the carotid artery and the cavernous sinus. Very dilated, multifocal communication, and sometimes you actually see this crossing to the other side, like in here, and you see also increased pressure and the dilatation of the superior thalamic vein on the right side. The CT angiogram at the time confirm this carotid cavernous fistula, and you see these communications and you see these markedly dilated vessels on the lateral view. So we brought the patient for treatment by endovascular. This is a right-sided injection. As you can see here, there is flow to the right hemisphere, as well as most of the flow to the left hemisphere is actually arising probably from the right side. And when we inject the diseased side, you see that there is no flow. We're injecting now from the left side. This is the left side. And you see no flow almost at all reaching the brain. The way we treat this, we cross through the normal artery from normal side to normal side. We bypass the site of all these communications, whether one or multiple. In this case, there were multiple communications. We make sure that we are in the right place. And this is a microcatheter crossing, and we inject distal to see that we are inside the branches of the middle cerebral artery. Then we put some flow diverters, and we do the injection afterwards, and as you can see here, there is almost immediate stagnation of flow that goes into the communication, and most of the flow now goes to the brain. And when the patient comes back for the follow-up, like what we had today after more than 2 years. This was the angiogram as a follow-up before, and then comes back now, and there is very good flow still through the parent artery. No occlusion and good flow to the left hemisphere, and on the venous MR venogram, you see no more communication between the artery and the vein.